a moment just to explain the time of COVID. My father, I am masked not because we are outside and need to be masked, but because I was exposed to someone with COVID last Sunday. They subsequently been hospitalized. Take your two tests, both of which are regular. But in abundance of caution, I am wearing a mask today and will be keeping my distance. I'm going to try and switch microphones here. See if this will work. Is this any better?
Yeah.
All right, wonderful. So, that's the explanation. It's up to you whether you choose to be masked or not. I will be keeping my distance, but for those reasons. Now, let us continue with our worship of morning prayer. The hour is coming, and now is, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For such the Father seeks, to worship Him. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God,
we confess our sins against you, Father.
Let us read Psalm 84 responsibly by verse. How dear to me is your dwelling, O Lord of hosts! My soul has a desire and longing for the courts of the Lord. My heart and my flesh rejoice in the living God. Happy are they who dwell in your house. They will always be praising you.
Happy are the people whose strength is in you, whose hearts are set on the pilgrim's way.
Those who go through the desolate valley will find it a place of springs, for the early rains have covered it with pools of water.
They will climb from height to height, and the God of God will reveal himself on Zion.
Lord God of hosts, hear my prayer. Hearken, O God of Jacob.
Behold our defender, O God, and look upon the face of your anointed.
For one day in your courts is better than a thousand in my own room, and to stand at the threshold of the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of the wicked.
For your God is the sun and shield, your grace and glory.
No good thing will the Lord withhold from those who walk with integrity.
O Lord of hosts, have your way with their trust in you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A reading from the first book of Kings. Then Solomon stood before the altar of the Lord in the presence of all the assembly of Israel, and spread out his hands to heaven. He said, O Lord, God of Israel, there is no God like you in heaven above or on earth beneath, keeping covenant and steadfast love for your servants who walk before you with all their heart, the covenant that you kept for your servant, my father David, as you declared to him. You promised with your mouth and have this day fulfilled with your hand. Therefore, O Lord God of Israel, keep for your servant, my father David, that which you promised him, saying, there shall never fail you a successor before me to sit on the throne of Israel. If only your children look to their way, to walk before me as you have walked before me. Therefore, O God of Israel, let your word be confirmed, which you promised to your servant, my father David. But will God indeed dwell on the earth? Even heaven and the highest heaven cannot contain you, much less this house that I have built. Regard your servant's prayer and his plea, O Lord my God, heeding the cry and the prayer that your servant prays to you today, that your eyes may be open night and day toward this house, the place of which you said, my name shall be there, that you may heed the prayer that your servant prays toward this place. Hear the plea of your servant and of your people Israel when they pray towards this place. O hear in heaven your dwelling place, heed and forgive. Likewise, when a foreigner who is not of your people Israel comes from a distant land because of your name, for they shall hear of your great name, your mighty hand, and your outstretched arm. When a foreigner comes and prays toward this house, then hear in heaven your dwelling place, and do according to all that foreigner calls to you, so that all the peoples of the earth may know your name and fear you, as do your people Israel, and so that we may know that your name has been invoked on this house that I have built. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Our second lesson is from Ephesians. Be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his power. Put on the whole armor of God so that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For our struggle is not against enemies of blood and flesh, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, so that you may be able to withstand on that evil day, and, having done everything, to stand firm. Stand therefore, and fasten the belt of truth around your waist, and put on the breastplate of righteousness. As shoes for your feet, put on whatever will make you ready to proclaim the gospel of peace. With all of these, take the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times, in every prayer and supplication. To that end, keep alert and always persevere in supplication for all the saints. Pray also for me, so that when I speak, a message may be given to me to make known with boldness the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it boldly, as I must speak. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me, and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so whoever eats me will live because of me." This is the bread that came down from heaven. not like that which your ancestors ate and died. But the one who eats this bread will live forever." He said these things while he was teaching in the synagogue at Capernaum. When many of his disciples heard it, they said, "This teaching is difficult. Who can accept it?" But Jesus, being aware that his disciples were complaining about it, said to them, "Does this offend you? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is useless. The words I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But among you there are some who do not believe." For Jesus knew from the first who were the ones that did not believe, and who was the one that would betray him. And he said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted by the Father." Because of this, many of his disciples turned back and no longer went about with him. So Jesus asked the 12, "Do you also wish to go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom can we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and know that you are the Holy One of God." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May I speak to you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Happy are the people whose hearts are set on the pilgrim's way. This verse, taken from our Psalm 84 for today, seems particularly appropriate to me for this occasion where we gather to remember all those who have gone before and who have been interred here in the Memorial Garden or Joy Cemetery. Now, this is a rare thing. Maybe I can't say unique because I don't know that, but it's a rare thing among churches. In the Episcopal Church, we often, on All Saints Day, have the reading of the necrology, those who have died in the previous year, in which we commemorate them and give thanks for their lives. But this place, St. Michael's in the Hills, year after year, makes this intentional act of coming together in this sacred place and remembering and naming all those who have gone before. And it's an extraordinary thing. But I think what really makes it extraordinary too is it gives us a chance to pause and remember this notion of the pilgrim's way. So in the psalm, it's talking about the highs and the lows in life that we encounter, but by and large throughout, and it concludes always with a sense of exaltation, of joy, even in the face of adversity. The pilgrim's way looks this way. And said another way, so do our lives look this way. We have high points and joy, points of joy and exaltation. We have low points of grief and sorrow. There's a great deal in between. It's not consistency, and it's certainly not perfection. In fact, none of those who we have laid to rest in these places were perfect in their lives, not in their own vocation and doing and living, but they were made perfect by the rituals that they maintained. Coming together and eating his blood and eating his flesh and drinking his blood on a regular occasion. Coming together for that communion as a body, bringing us all together collectively as one. Those were the highlights, and those were the points that actually sustain us through those highs and lows throughout our life. So we can look at the points on either ends of the markers, the date of birth and the date of death. Those just begin to define the pilgrim's way. The date of death is not the end of the way, but rather is the beginning of that transcendent way that we all look forward to, life everlasting. Now those who have met that point do lie in rest and perfection in God's kingdom. The rest of us, like the audience before Jesus in the gospel lesson today. Well, we are just trying to live life. So let me put it a little bit in context, what Capernaum is. Capernaum is a port city on the Sea of Galilee, and a thriving commercial and industrial center, and a place of commerce, and it's also a place of worship. There was a prominent synagogue there. And it was also a place of occupation. The Romans maintained a garrison camp there, and also it was a place where the taxes were taken in. So it sounds familiar to many of us, and they could be even Toledo, but with the absence of the Roman garrison. So this is the life we live, in which much of our life is defined, at least by the world around us. It is one of commerce and of consuming and seeking and grasping. The pilgrim's way that Jesus presents is very different, and this is why it is a hard lesson and why some began to turn away. This idea that he was asking people to turn away from the life they knew and lived day to day and do something extraordinary, to set themselves aside as those who consumed his blood, his body and his blood, and to live in a different plan of self-denial. Those who came before us did not do that perfectly. We will, none of us will do it perfectly. But we are on the pilgrim's way, even as we speak, because we are here today. And we will be here next year, and the next year, until we are made perfect in God's kingdom. So this, I think, is the message from the gospel lesson and the psalm today, is keep putting one foot in front of the other, but never forget to make time for the communion in the body and blood of Jesus Christ in company with the other saints. And never forget those who went before us, because they set the path that guides us.
Let us say together the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day,
the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, and thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom,
save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them now and always.
Day by day, we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
Grant, O merciful God, that your church, being gathered together in unity by your Holy Spirit, may show forth your power among all peoples to the glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
be seated. Well, the announcements are made infinitely easier by the enclosed flyer that is in your bulletin. And so rather than narrate, or rather read them all to you, I will commit it to you to read at your leisure. But please do read it. But I also want to make sure I'm not overlooking any other announcements. Are there other announcements for the good of the order? Well, this may go on the record as being one of the shortest announcement periods ever. But I do commend you to pay attention, to look at it with attention, because there are a lot of things happening this in the next month and going forward. Exciting things. It's been fun to be working with the programming committee and pulling this all together. I hope you will take advantage of the opportunities that are presented. Now, walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Stand as you are able.
We lift to God all who have asked our prayers, especially Kay, Al, Dick, Elmer, Letty, Carol, Dennis, Gail, Jackie, John, Marilyn, Lindsay, Lillian, Dee Dee, Dixie, Evelyn, Lee, Jean, Karen, Lexi, Sandra, Nancy, Bill, Rod, Joan, Ginger, Terry, Paula, Malcolm, and Bill. We also pray for all those infected with COVID-19 and their caregivers. Are there any you wish to name? We lift to God those in harm's way, especially Michael, Ian, John, Scott, and Russell, and all essential workers. Are there any you wish to name? We thank you, Lord, for all the blessings of this life. Are there any thanksgivings you'd like to offer? We pray for all who have died, those who are dying, and those who mourn. Are there any you wish to name? Please be seated. We pray for those buried in the Memorial Garden, and parishioners enjoy cemeteries. Those interred in the Memorial Garden: Caroline Alexander, Harold Alexander, Evelina Alter, Nicholas Alter, Nicholas Alter Jr., Edward Ames, Catherine Ames, Mary Ames, Bernice Aston, John Aston, Bobby Augenbaugh, Joy Augenbaugh, Elizabeth Bailey, Stevie Bailey, Robert Bailey, Marguerite Barnett, Andrew Barone, Sandra Barone, Bertha Bennett, Jeffrey Bennett, Judith Bennett, William H. Black III, Alva Blakely, Kathleen Blakey, Lawrence Basil, Milton Basil, Robert Bogart, Sally Bogart, John Boyce, Willis Boyce, Carl Boyer, Joanne Boyer, Marion Boyer, Charlotte Branham, Jean Bresman, Stephanie Bresman, Paul Brooks, Alice Brooks, Willis Brown, Marshall Birch, Donald Burgess, Joan Burgess, Ann Burns, Robert Burns, Ruth Carmi, Jack Christopher, Charles Duffy Cobaugh Jr., Gene Cochran, Ralph Cochran, Benjamin Coe, Malcolm Crowther, Eleanor Davies, Mary Jane Dagus, Jane DeVilbiss, Lucille Drumheller, John Drumheller, Hayward Drummond, Anthony Duncan, Martin Duncan, Jean Duncan, John Aney, Ruth Aney, Janet Esch, Raymond Esch, Janelle Falter, Harold Fitkin, Pauline Fox, Margaret Fitz, James Gilbert, Jane Gilbert, James Gleason, Mary Gleason, John Gray, Virginia Gray, Jane Gregory, Diana Griffin, John Griffin, George Haig, the Reverend Lawrence Hall, Sarah Hall, Mary Hallar, James Hancock, Peter Handwerk, Claudia Hannaford, the Reverend Paul Hannaford, Thomas Henderson, Paul Rusty Heyman, Anna Mary Haywood, William Haywood, Howard Hall, Irene Hall, Anna Jacobus, Harold Jost, Rhoda Doe Jost, Dorothy Karabedian, James Karabedian, Millie Kovac, Michael Lambier, Hugh Laughlin, Isabel Laughlin, John Laughlin, Chadwick Lane, Joan Lee, Lucille Lehman, George Lehman Jr., George Daniel Lehman III, Shirley Lindeen, Betty Lipton, Alan Loop, Eleanor Loop, Alma Ludlow, Paul Marion, William Mason, David Mather, Joseph Mather Jr., Alan Mayer, Anne McArdle, Michael McConnell, Grace Mollie, Grace Moore, Robert Moore, Sarah Moore, Elizabeth Shelley Morris, Eugene Muckensturm, Anna Muckensturm, James Yoon, Nancy Yoon, Charles Mulliken, Catherine Myers, Richard Newell, Maurice O'Connell, Julia Orwig, Kenneth Orwig Jr., Alan Owen, Marion Owen, Russell Reynolds, Theodore Roberts, Frank Rossnagel, Harold Rudolph, Lillian Rudolph, Nancy Rudolph, H. Allen Rudolph, Charles Salestead, Christopher Salestead, Harold Sauer, Gene Sauer, Gene Schaefer, Lawrence Schaefer, Enid Schnitker, Max Schnitker, Paul Schnitker, Eleanor Seyfried, Patricia Seyfried, John Shelley, Lois Shelley, Philip Simons, Margaret Spangler, Lillian Stevens, Conrad Stolzenbach, Norma Stolzenbach, Lee Stout, Rita Stout, Benjamin Taylor, Edna Taylor, Jacqueline Thomas, Noble Utley, John Wagoner, Charlton Whittier, Richard Whittier, Ruth Whittier, John Wiley, Anita Whitty, John Whitty, Otto Whitman, Margaret Whitman, Robert Wolfe, and June Wolfe. Communicants of St. Michael's buried in Joy Cemetery: Daryl Blanchard, Samuel Bowers, Henry Brunsting, David Curtis, Geraldine Curtis, Michael Davies, Robert Davies, Western Gardner, Archer Gartner, Evie Gartner, Dean Overmeyer, Lucille Overmeyer, Leroy Rabuck, Helen Rabuck, Henry Rudy, Nell Rudy, Lance Hunter Smith, Margaret Galpin Smith, Robert Campbell Smith Sr., Charles Waldorf, George Ward, Jane Ward, James White, Nelda White, and Jane Youngen.
Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting joy through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Praying together, Lord, make us instruments of your peace.
Where there is hatred, let us love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, union. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. Grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is the giving that we receive, it is the pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is the dying that we are warned with eternal life. Amen.
Almighty and ever-living God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
pray together. Almighty God,
Father of all mercies, we are humbly here, give you all thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and all of you in the earth. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life. And above all, we are in the world, and we enter into the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the need for grace and for the hope of glory.
Thank you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.